told people that I am not kidding you, this will be a rough one.
Shortly before 4 p.m., the pilot attempted an emergency landing.
I think I heard the wheels touch the runway, but after that, it was nothing but horrendous, horrific noise. And it just became black. It was black and the noise and the metal. It went on forever. It seemed like it didn't stop. One of the very first things that I remember hearing after that is I heard a man's voice shouting, "You can't go out that way. There's fire there." You could already smell the fuel. And also remember is unbuckling my seatbelt.
In the moments after the crash, Jimmy experienced another perceptual change reported by many survivors. Tongue distortion.
It went on forever. It seemed like it didn't stop. I really don't have any idea. I've been told that it was probably seconds, maybe a minute and a half. I really don't have any way of knowing. I think when you're in a situation like that, you don't have any time concept. To me, it seemed like maybe a minute and a half, maybe seconds.
Your sense of how fast or slow time is moving changes. And most of the time, you begin to see time as going by very, very slowly. What's happening is your brain is shifting into a higher gear, and it's taking in more information. And as a result of this, you get a sense of time is going on, but it's only your brain shifting operations. It is now operating more effectively and faster than before. It is a good thing, because it means that you're now paying very close attention indeed to the environment and to what's going on around you, and that it will help you survive and will help you make the right decision. While tongue distortion has saved Judy, it came at the expense of other brain functions. She doesn't remember much about how she got out, and the parts she thinks she remembers are wrong.
They said, "Well, we were upside down." I said, "Well, I wasn't upside down." And they said, "Well, did you see the lights?" I said, "Well, no, I didn't see the lights." And they said, "Well, that's because they were above you."
Essentially, what's happening here is that the brain is diverting resources away from normal processes, normal memory, normal thinking. All of that, in a sense, has been starved, and it's been shunted somewhere else. Afterwards, it means that your recollection of what happened in the game is sticking, flawed, unusual. You can think that stuff did happen when in reality it didn't. And you can be convinced that you're correct and that your recollection is correct, but it isn't.
It took one of the National Guardsmen who brought in pictures and showed me that the plane was upside down to finally convince me.
Professor Self believes that when our brains change in the process, increase our chances of survival. But only up to a point. There is a limit to how much stress we can handle. Up until a certain point, it's good. It helps improve your performance. But once you go past this threshold, your performance begins to collapse. Your ability to cope, your ability to concentrate, your ability to focus, disappears. other people to do before they die.